colorful political rallies and charged crowds. Images many wouldn't expect from Somalia. But Northwest Somalia, or Somaliland as its people have called it, has proven to be more progressive than the rest of the country. As the presidential campaigns wind up, there is strong talk of the possibility of a change of guard, no mean feat for this state in waiting. Opinion polls are unheard of here, but if the huge turnouts opposition parties have been getting at their campaign rallies are anything to go by, President Dahir Riale Kahin is facing the biggest political battle of his lifetime. He's been in office for 8 years, and now his opponents say it's time for change. President Kahin says he will have no regrets if he loses the elections.
I believe I've made a sacrifice for this country to the continuity of the system, and also doing another the security, empowering the security, training the security people in neighboring countries so that the standard of our security will get up. So I think I have done more than I can do.
A former intelligence officer, the current president credits himself with most of the progress Somaliland has achieved in the past 8 years. It's Ahmed Mohammed Silanyo, the leader of Somaliland's main opposition Kulmiye party, who poses the most formidable challenge to President Kahin's rule. Having lost out by a mere 80 votes in the last presidential elections, Silanyo feels it's now the time to claim the top post, with his the loudest voice calling for change.
There's so many things have gone wrong. There has not been much in the way of development. There has not been much in the way of strengthening relations with the international community, and in so many other things, and all the different needs of the nation.
The Party for Justice and Social Welfare, or UID, the country's second largest opposition party, has also been attracting a huge following across Somaliland. Its leaders are confident the public display of goodwill for their party will translate into votes and victory. The party also got an unexpected boost of support when it announced it will establish Islamic law if it wins.
It's the obligation of Islam, of every Muslim leader, to protect Islam. And to, if he's the ruler of Islam, he has to use Sharia, and that's what we are doing here.
These elections are seen as crucial to the continued stability of Somaliland. And though divided in their support for the different parties, the people here are unified in their hope for peaceful polls. Mohammed Adow, Al Jazeera, Hargeysa, Somaliland.